Once I have eaten my breakfast, I kind of eat like the same breakfast every single day, unless I'm rushing out the door, and then I'll have like a little breakfast sandwich, which I've been into lately. But the egg white veggie omelet really fills me up, and it's like my favorite way to start the day, especially with those Vans waffles. So good. What I wanted to show you guys was something that I personally do. I tell pretty much all of my clients to do this as well, so I'm going to share this with you. And I have made a video on this in the past as far as planning for the weekend and how to plan your meals ahead of time in MyFitnessPal. What I personally do after I've had my breakfast is I go in and I just add everything that I ate. And like I said, this is pretty much the same thing that I have all the time. I just go in and adjust the ratios. Super easy. So I kind of have memorized what I eat just because I do it so often. So for this, as you guys saw, I had some spinach, mushrooms, egg whites, 2 slices of chicken bacon, half a serving of almond cheese, and then those Vans gluten cinnamon waffles. I do not weigh out spinach, and I don't even log that like little tomato onion salsa thing because it's so small. It would probably be just like 1 gram of carb, if that. And so I don't personally. If you want to, you can. I just don't feel like it's necessary. The only reason why I log like the spinach and the mushrooms, even though I don't weigh them, is just because I like to see how it impacts my micronutrients. So like I said, I've been doing this for so long that I know what 20 grams of spinach looks like, and I know what 30 grams of mushrooms look like, so I can get a rough idea. It's not gonna be perfect, but totally not the end of the world. I just like it for the micronutrient purpose. That was what I had for breakfast. Now I am going to head to the gym to do my training, which I'll bring you guys along with, because when I asked on my Instagram what you guys like to see, 90% of you liked the daily vlogs. And it's funny because I struggle with this, and I always feel like, oh, I'm so boring, like I don't have anything fun to do. But I guess like the daily things of me just doing life is what you guys like. So that's what I'm gonna do today along with this full day of eating. And so I train first, and then I coach the noon class. So I am at the gym from 10 to 1, and then I'll be home to make my lunch. Morgan's coming over today. I have some new things I want to show you for lunch I'm so excited about. And then I will just carry on with the rest of my day. So that is what's going on. Now, I will say, if you want to, you can do this in MyFitnessPal the night before and plan out the whole day. Today, because I'm doing something a little different for lunch and I need to be able to adjust it when I get to lunch, I'm not going to do that. But if you are just starting out and you want to be as accurate with your macros as possible, I do recommend sitting down the night before and planning out your following day. This just also gives you an opportunity to get more familiar with MyFitnessPal, because you can see how certain things are affecting your intake. A lot of times, if people log things as they're going, they're not really able to see the like amount that it's affected the rest of their day. And then they'll get to the end of the day and have like an awkward amount of food left over, and then they get frustrated. So that's why I like to be prepared. I like to do it either the morning of or the night before. And I definitely recommend that for you guys as well. Now that I'm done with that, I'm gonna go ahead and hit the gym and I will see you guys there. So before I get into the terrible workout today, that is Fran's older brother, I have every 2 minutes for 8 minutes, incline dumbbell press and dumbbell high pulls. But the WOD today is Fran, except an AMRAP. If you don't know what Fran is 21-15-9 thrusters and pull-ups at 65 pounds for women, 95 pounds for men. You have to pace Fran, which Fran is not normally a pacing workout. You just go balls out for Fran. My best Fran time was, I think, ooh, I have to find the video. I think it's 232, which is pretty decent because my pull-ups are good, but I don't know how many I'm gonna be able to get, how many rounds during a 14-minute AMRAP. So we're gonna get started and I'll show you guys the Fran. For the last 21 thrusters, and then I tried to hold on at the end, but my ripped hand hurt so bad. I'm so mad that that wasn't recording. So now it's like I didn't even do it. Wow.
Oh, check out those nobles though. Yes, yes. Super quick before Morgan and I go to film this video. This is my post training meal. It's leftover, so I didn't cook anything. It's just jasmine rice, broccoli, carrots, chickpeas, and chicken thighs with some of this Hidden Valley Greek yogurt dressing. So this will be my first meal, but then I know I'm gonna be hungry in about an hour, so I'm gonna eat something else after that.
Okay, so it has been a couple hours. I will tell you guys, I had 160 grams of strawberries and then half of a Nougat chocolate pretzel bar because Morgan and I were filming a sister tag video, and so I was kind of snacking while I was doing that, but my camera was in use, so I wasn't able to show you. But right when I was about to finish prepping my chicken thighs, this delivery of purple carrot came in, and I was going to make more chicken thighs and boar for dinner and show you guys that, but then I thought to myself, this is the perfect time because a lot of you are saying that I make the same foods over and over again and I don't do anything creative and some of my stuff is not vegan. And I fully support veganism. I love the morality behind it. As much as I can, I try to reduce animal, you know, consumption, whether it be from makeup, hair products, any companies that are cruelty-free. I support like Tula's cruelty-free, and things like that. You know, I do what I can because I am personally not vegan, but I did find this company called Purple Carrot. Before I go to my facial, I have a facial at 4 o'clock, it's 3:30 now, so I just kinda wanted to go through this with you guys before I make it later. I am so pumped about this because this is a plant-based meal prep, if you will, company. And essentially, they provide you with the ingredients in their box. So like, I'll tell you guys what I got, just because I wanted to get things that I personally enjoy. And the ingredients come like this. So for example, this is the crunchy Thai vegetable salad and everything is in there. And then you use the little reference book to show you like, you know, exactly how to prepare it. Aha bowls, this is probably what I'm gonna make tonight. It shows you like how to make it, you know, what you'll need, this, that, and the other. And it also has the macros, which I'm so excited about. So this baja bowl with crispy hearts of palm and mango salsa is 530 calories, 2.5 grams of fat, 89 carb, and 23 protein. Of course, obviously, like, you can swap out things if you need, but I feel like this is, in my opinion, would be a good opportunity for somebody who wants to eat more plant-based but doesn't necessarily know how, and it kind of takes, like, the time aspect out of it because you're not going to the grocery store, like, digging around for, you know, certain plant-based things and trying to figure out. This kind of simplifies it for you. So, like, if you're somebody with a busy schedule or something like that, this would be really beneficial. What I'm really excited for is the multi-grain flatbread pizzas. So I'm really looking forward to making this. It's Mediterranean flatbread with, like, dried apricots and chickpeas, which is one of my favorite things. So I'm very excited to try this because I have been wanting to incorporate some more plant-based meals into my diet. I just think, you know, there's no harm in trying new things and expanding my way of eating. And obviously, you know, I know a ton of you guys who watch me are vegan or vegetarian and looking for new recipes. So I'm really excited to share this with you guys. So once I go to my facial and come back, I will make my dinner. And as of right now, let me give you guys a little macro update here. I have eaten 66 grams of protein, 127 carb, and 25 fat. So I have 64 grams of protein left, 103 grams of carbs left, and 35 fat. So this, any of these meals really will fit perfectly into my macros. So either the pizza or the Baja bowl, haven't fully decided yet, is what I'll make when I get back. But I'm really excited about it. So yeah, I'm going to go get my face all beautified, take a shower before I head out, and then I will be back with you guys for the dinner meal. Really good. Okay, so the lime definitely brings it together, and I'm glad I put extra on top. I put some on the salsa, which, like, with the mango and the cilantro and black beans, which is really good. And I was able, it said that I was supposed to, like, fry the hearts of palm with vegetable oil, but I don't have vegetable oil. So I just sprayed some regular oil, like the spray oil in my pan. But I don't know if you guys can see this, like, hold on. It actually got so crispy. You hear that? To give it, like, a, I don't know, like, to give it a taste, a description is really difficult. It's not like, oh, I don't know how to explain it. It's really good though. Like, honestly, I would never think that, like, oh, this doesn't have that much protein in it. I think the hearts of palm are really good. So the Swiss chard also really has, like, a nice bittery, peppery taste to it. Like, it's not as bland as spinach, but it's not as bitter as kale. I feel like it's maybe in between. But this is really good. I had a little bit more. Like, this was supposed to be separated into two servings, but I kind of gave myself maybe, like, a serving and a half or a serving and a third. I am so, so impressed. Awesome job, Purple Carrot. I'm really excited to try the other meals during the remainder of the week, so I will keep you guys updated on that for sure. But all of the produce was really good. Mango was amazing. Oh, I freaking love mango so much. What I loved about this one in comparison to other like prepping companies like this is that this one did not have that much sodium. Like for this meal, it was only, I think, 490 milligrams. And then like some of the other companies that I've looked at before, their sodium can be upwards of like 1600 milligrams, even 2000 milligrams for just one meal. And so me personally, I just like to keep my sodium a little bit lower. I can physically feel it when I eat a really high sodium meal. So I don't know, this is perfect. I'm so surprised I've never tried Hearts of Palm before because I actually really like it. It doesn't have a distinct taste though. Like it's not like really overpowering. I've never had tofu either, but that's in one of the meals I have, so I'm excited to try and see if I like that as well. But
meat eater.
Yeah.
Tasting a vegan dish.
It's very good.
Yay.
It's very, very good actually.
Oh, I was so surprised at those Hearts of Palm. What would you say it tastes like? I couldn't really put my finger on it. It's like, wants to be a starch, but.
Yeah, I don't know what to compare it to. Actually, it's got a little bit of salty taste to it.
Yeah.
But I don't know that I can put my finger on exactly what it would be comparable to.
I know, me neither. Oh, I'm so glad you like it though.
It is good though.
Yay.
So, I was gonna end my full day of eating video, but then I broke my hand at the gym. So, I don't have anything else to show you guys because we stopped at Whitey's on the way back from the emergency room. It was luckily just a freak accident. It wasn't from lifting. I was coaching, and then I got my hand stuck between a barbell and the rig, trying to pick someone's weight up, and it was not fun. And my fourth metacarpal is broken in the middle, but it's okay. So my actual nightcap is going to be Whitey's Grand Central Station, not tracked macros and not given a shit because I got a broken hand. So that's where we're in today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Please give the video a thumbs up and I will see you guys in my next one.